Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Trophinet, and welcome back to our Let's Replay series in Bioshock 2. As you can hear, shit is still hitting the fan. We're in Siren Alley, and I think two splices are still attacking a Big Daddy over here, yeah. And apparently that Big Daddy was waiting to fire his rocket launcher until I got around the corner. So that guy over there with that fiery red health bar is a Rumbler. A new kind of Big Daddy that has a rocket launcher and can lob any sort of grenades. So yeah, one big motherfucker. Let's start off by talking a bit about Siren's Alley. This is actually pretty cool. So there's candles next to a painting of the crashed airplane that Jack Ryan was in. Because that kind of indicates that they kind of worship him right now. So let's listen to A Silent God.
Lord, what more do you wish of me? Your wretch of a servant waits for word. I have followed the letter of the Holy Mother Lamb, though she will not tell me the day of your return. I watched as you smote down the false father, Andrew Ryan, who tempted us away from your radiant gaze. But you would not speak to me, Lord. I have built for you this great temple and gathered your flock, yet still you were silent. Will you not strike me poor brother blind, so he may at last behold your glory, as was done to Paul on the road to Damascus? I am alone, Lord, alone, and waiting for a sign.
So there we go, because Jack Ryan killed Andrew Ryan, the false shepherd. Father Wales believes that he was sent by God. It's also indicated that Father Wales actually has a brother who isn't as faithful as he is. Siren Alley, a very interesting area, because this area is filled with bars and, yeah, it's kind of the red light district of Rapture, which makes it ironic to have a very, very big man of faith in this area walking around, so Father Wales. So there's still a few splices running around, as we can hear, and there's a nice tonic over there as well. Hello, Mr. Rumbler. Okay, let's try and bypass these guys. There we go, and I'm wondering, do I still need to research? Ooh, I still need to research these guys. Hi! Is there another one? Or was that just a grenade? Probably just a grenade. Nope, there's still another splicer up there. Ow, 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 ow. Goodbye. Okay, that kind of hurt, but luckily that first aid kit helped me out a bit. So let's take a look around, because there's a lot to do here. So hello, Mr. Rumbler, should I attack you already? Kind of wondering if I should. I have a few heavy rivets, not that much though. Could use telekinesis to bounce everything back at him, so that might actually give us a try. Let's see. Hi. There we go. Let's try and swap out. Okay, that was a miss. Oh, I needed to reload there. That was annoying. So the other things he fires are actually mini turrets. There we go. Grand Daddy, indeed. So I think that's for killing three Big Daddies without dying. Not harvest, adopt. I still am going for the triangle button for some reason. So that was the Rumbler, quickly taken care of. So there we go, a mini turret. And mini turrets are actually the third option for our remote hack dart thingy. Because now we can set up mini turrets as well, the same as this guy did, the Rumbler did. But you can take care of those mini turrets when using telekinesis. If you pick them up with telekinesis, they become, not harmful anymore, so harmless. Okay, nope. Give me that Eve hypo, thank you. And let's take a look here. There we go. Got a bit of drill fuel. Always helpful, that is. Maybe one first aid kit. Good on drill fuel, and actually, yeah, remote hack darts as well. So let's keep it at that. Phosphorus buck, that's actually very interesting. So that's the explosive buck from the previous game, causing fiery explosions. Let's go to the end of this area first and see what's around here. Because I think the marker leads us to the end first because of where we need to go. Hello, sir.
Ryan lives. Gather the family.
So that was Father Wales himself.
Mother of mercy, I think that was Simon Wales. What's he done to himself? He and his brother were Rapture's architects, but when Dark Lamb came along, Simon got religion. He's got a kind of church down in the pumping station. Expect a reckoning when you arrive.
So there we go, confirming that the two brother Wales were actually kind of founding fathers of Rapture, so they were responsible for the creation of Rapture. And, well, another interesting thing is the last name of Sophia and Eleanor, of course. Lamb confirms to, refers to the Lamb of God, of course. And that's why Mr. Wales believes that Sophia is, a religious woman. Not that she is, because we know that. Because she wouldn't let somebody shoot himself in the face. I wonder if I go up here, if I can get inside that area downstairs. Seems like we can. Because I want that tonic. Seems like he can run around here as well. Some more trap rivets will be handy when we start harvesting. Okay, hi. Somebody killed herself here. Anything else? Seems like this was some sort of drug lab. I go by this stuff over here. Artisan distilled water. Yeah, and then the bathtub. Seems like they were making drugs in here. But let's drop down and see if we can get that tonic. There we go. That's very tempting, but let's check this place out first. Trap rivets, more trap... Oh, that's all we can carry, apparently. Anti-personnel rounds, that's very handy. And some more food. Anything else in the refrigerators? Heavy rivets. And an Eve hypo at the opportune moment. And then, what is this room? So that's that will allow us to go back outside. I'm not going to open that just yet, just in case we get ambushed when we pick up the tonic. So yeah, let's pick up that thing first, because I'm not really sure what that is. Let's see, handyman. Oh, that's a very, very cool one. When your security friends take a bullet for you, put them back into tip-top shape with a bit of Eve. So that will allow us to, repair and name friendly bots and turrets by interacting with them. And the naming part is also very cool. I feel it's pretty cool. So now we can give a name to our turret. So let's listen to this one.
Well, Mr. Diary, Mom's got a new security system to stop me from seeing Amir and the other kids. But security's just made of bits and bobs, like you are. And now we're the best of friends. Isn't that right? Anyway, Amir's got a whole book about the surface. It has India and Ireland and everywhere. Yes, all right, Mr. Diary. If you must know, I do think Amir's kind of pretty for a dog eater. Oh no! Retreat!
Eleanor, come back here at once.
So there we go. The tonic actually belonged... I kind of want to think that the tonic belongs to Eleanor and that she used that thing to repair and name her security apparatuses that she got her hands on. Let's hack the door in the meantime. There we go. And that's, another little gift of Eleanor, I like to think. Even though it's not marked as one. I do like to think that's one of hers. Let's... What the... Okay, hi.
Send your daughter.
There we go.
Daddy, that's
dancing.
Yes, she is dancing indeed. Let's check out the Gatherer's Garden while we're at it. So we could go for the upgrades again. Move through the world as an invisible plasmid-wielding scout. That's actually very interesting as well. Incinerate 2. Light up the room with the new firebomb ability. So, in stark contrast to the previous game, the upgrades for the main plasmids don't actually just reinforce the effect, they actually add extra abilities. So Incinerate 2 adds a firebomb ability, allowing you to, well, toss firebombs. An electro bolt 2 allows you to, well, adds chain lightning to the normal electro bolt. What does Winter Blast 2 actually does? Freeze your foes in a solid ice block. And Hypnotize 2 charge up to befriend splicers to join your cause. And this is a very interesting one. I do like Cyclone Trap 2 because we can charge up your traps with plasmids for a variety of effects. So we can actually make fire cyclone traps and everything like that. Telekinesis 2 allows you to throw harder for more damage. So that's just a boost. Ooh, Electric Flash. Huh, and Walking Inferno. So how much do I have? 85. So if I buy another Gene Tonic slot, there we go. Let's just put Boost Hand there for now. And then go for Electric Flash, because I really like Electric Flash. There we go. That's a nice boost. So now we deal more damage if we use electrical attacks. So handy on both Big Daddies and Big Sisters if the need arises. So let's just follow the arrow for now. And that will lead us in the right direction. Her vanquished captor's effigy. So yeah, that's vanquished captor. So that's us, a doll about us. And that's a little sister on top of a corpse. And a little sister depicted as a holy being. Because we've been seeing that a lot. Little sisters being worshipped as gods.
I think Mother knows I'm helping you like this. She's accelerating my treatments. Don't give up on me.
We won't, Eleanor. We won't. So, Security Command. Take control of Rapture Security with Security Command. Enemy Security and your own friendly bots and turrets will follow the blue ball and attack with deadly force. So yeah, Security Bullseye from the previous game. Not really that handy. So I'm going to leave it at that. Anything else in this room? So now... Oh, yes, I do remember this room. So that's another... Well, that's a splicer perfectly set up to check out Security Command. But we're not going to do that just yet. Instead, we're just going to pop his face off. There we go. Let's hack the camera nonetheless. There we go. And now. You have to be careful because there's more bots, I think. Yeah, there's a turret up there. Somebody there? Can I... See the turret? No, I'm gonna get splashed. Oh! There we go. And where? There we go. She wanted to heal. I thought I heard something. That was a nice Rambo jump. There we go. Turret is ours. Now we can actually rename these guys, right? Wait. Oh no, it's broken. I can't hack this. It's supposed to be hacked already, but apparently that didn't work so well. Find the key code to access Plaza Hedon. So yeah, another thing you might have noticed is that a lot of places in Rapture are called after, are named after Greek gods and goddesses.
Looks like the good fathers kept up with the code locks. Time was, only way to join with Doc Lamb was to beg an audience with him first. Must be some side of that number lying around. See if you can find us a lead.
So there we go. And because we had, in the previous game, we had Mercury Suites, we had Apollo Square, we had Artemis Suites. Or was Artemis may have been in this game. Poseidon Plaza, we also had that. So yeah, a lot of Greek gods and goddesses. So, Lamb's Salvation.
Daniel, you You and I drafted Rapture's blueprint together. Wales and Wales, architects. Do you remember? But Andrew Ryan led us astray, my brother. Turned us from the Almighty. Dr. Lamb offers you salvation, Daniel. I ask only for proof that the barest flicker of faith remains in you. I left a gift for you at the Pink Pearl, in your offices. Find the code on it, brother. We shall pray together for your sorry soul.
So a desperate attempt of Father Wales to convert his brother Daniel to the faith. The faith not of gold as we know it, but of Lamb's religion. The faith of the family, of the little sister and of Adam. Seems like there's another brute splicer over there. So let's take a nice picture. Don't know if he noticed me already. What's this? What's this? Don't know why, but the brute splicer for some reason are all British. No, no, no. Boom, bitch! And then let's put you on fire. And down you go. Feel like there's... yeah. There we go. Kinda cost me a bit of drill fuel, but... hi. Yeah, I kinda forgot to make a picture of you before I killed your previous friend. Let's see. Should we do a gather before we go into any of the other areas?
I've got the maddening notion that I owe you my life, stranger. Such as it is. I'm sending you a care package to the Pneumo along the way. I'd appreciate it if you didn't tell Dr. Lamb.
So there we go. We get a bit of, benefit. Yeah, little sister, thank you. We get a bit of benefit from saving Grace Holloway in the previous episode. So now we got 2 auto-hack darts, 30 anti-personnel rounds, and 6 phosphorus buck. Which are really, really good against splicers, all of them are. Except for the auto-hack. And there's a little sister. Do you react to the other little sister, actually? Doesn't seem like she does. I'm gonna check out the mermaid launch on the other side here first. Because I think there's a few interesting things here. There we go.
How about a scary squirrel, little fire?
Did I? Yeah, not again. I do love the voice lines of the splicer sometimes. Not again! And she gets a drill to the face.
What competition?
Is there another one here? Seems like there's another one around here. But let's first check out the rest of this place. Hello? Seems like you can use a bit of fire in your life. Heavy rivets. And a dollar. Thought there was more. Yeah, Eve Hypo. Oh, and an audio diary. The Rumbler.
The rate of sister loss has become unacceptable as Big Daddies are brought down like elephants under a pack of hyenas. In response, we've begun production of a newly designed Big Daddy model, nicknamed the Rumbler. He launches high-explosive munitions to disperse groups of splicers, followed by miniature automated turrets to mop up the stragglers. Our tests find that the Rumbler's performance is highly effective, if messy. In Rapture's arms race, splicers aren't the only ones that are evolving.
So Gil Alexander confirming that he's actually the one that came up with the Rumbler model. And yeah. There we go. And that the Rumbler was actually necessary because the little sister started dying. Well, dying by the bunch, yeah, because the Big Daddies were killed pretty easily. Ooh. Huh. Seems like somebody got shot here. A long time ago, it seems, because he does look rather normal. Hello? Is there anything else in this room? Oh, yeah. Kind of a hidden compartment in the back here. Turret control. Let's take a picture first. And let's press the button.
You heard me.
Yep, there he goes. And there goes the other one. That was fun, let's do that again. Anything else? No, it doesn't seem like it. Oh, goes the weasel. Looks like they are mine. Hi. I think he died.
Sounds like Wales's brother Daniel operates the Pink Pearl now. That's a high-class brothel, son, on your side of the door. See if you can find that code with him.
So Daniel Wales is apparently still alive, but he owns a brothel in stark contrast to his holy brother. So, plasmid shipment?
Listen, my supplier's got a new shipment of plasmids coming in, and I need you to pick them up from the lab in Hedon Plaza. There's a hidden switch to open the back door. It's tucked away under the cash register in the shop front. And don't let nobody see you do it. Otherwise, we'll have splicers crawling all over the damn place trying to get a taste.
Ooh, 3 apples. Anything else? Let's start gambling again. There we go. Seems like we got the jackpot there. 650, so a full wallet. That's gonna come in handy, probably. But let's get back outside and let's go find that brothel. If we actually get out of here. Seems like somebody entered the building again. Can I actually go through here? Doesn't seem like it. Seems like there's a room back there as well. Oh yeah, right. We can use the remote hack dart. There we go.
Big sister doesn't like snowpokes.
Was she just threatening that big daddy with a big sister? That was creepy. Let's go with the auto hack dart. There we go. More anti-personnel rounds. I actually cannot carry them anymore. Let's drink and eat all that. Thank you for that. Eat my fill. And then let's check out the back room here. More food and drill fuel. That's gonna come in handy. Let's drop down. And then we have a power to the people station. I am wondering if I should put that over there, because that might actually be bad. So, we could get the drill reflector upgrade right now. I don't think it's necessary, because we could use the shotgun damage increase first. So let's do that. There we go. So now we have a shortened barrel, which means that we have a bigger damage output. Oh, fuck. So I think... Oh, shit. Ow. And we get a nice kick from the shotgun right now, so the sound effect is a bit off. Fuck. There we go, let's swap to anti-personnel rounds. Yeah, one more indeed. I'm glad you pointed that out, that I needed one more bullet to kill you, but there you go. I think I'm gonna check the upstairs again quickly, because I need those anti-personnel rounds really, 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 really fast. So give me those now, please. They're in the safe over here. There we go. And that should do it. There seems to be, heavy rivets. Thank you very much. Do need to keep my eye on everything over here. And then I think I'm gonna do a single harvest around here. This is a pretty hard area to defend. But if I'm not mistaken, wasn't there a corpse here? Probably missed it again. It's not over here, it's probably on the other side. I know there's one upstairs as well. Might be a better position for us to defend. So let's take the one upstairs, set up some traps, and see what happens. So yeah, this one. I don't think they can come from the back. There's even one right over here.
Ah!
There we go. An A for that. Let's reload. Maybe even take Phosphorus Buck. Causing fiery explosions, which sounds good. Then take some trap rivets, and I'm gonna blister this entire place with those. Oh shit. That was annoying. Splicer got in the way of my traps and triggered them already. Now let's see, I'm gonna put a few cyclone traps down as well so you can see those in action. A few right around here. They do cost a bit of Eve. I think I can put four down for each bar of Eve. And let's put one over here. And then I'm gonna hide out here in the room. So that should give me a nice vantage point to hide away from. So, gather Adam. And let's keep shocking. Yeah. Let's keep Electrobolt in play. Let's see what. Oh no! Oh no! He's not triggering. Okay, he's not triggering the rest of the trap rabbits. I hope that wasn't a big daddy, because otherwise I'm gonna be bugged. I think the big daddy is a bit pissed. I don't think anything is happening. Ah, and there she goes, with her head in the ceiling.
No strength! No! Don't let him get me, Daddy!
Yeah? You need to be careful not to hit the... Think someone, yeah, trap master, there we go, killed a lot of splicers with traps. Ow! Oh, there she goes. There we go. Pick up. Yeah, yeah, I know, we're rivals, never mind, let it go. Let's take all the trap rivets. Kind of misguessed where they were coming from, but...
Faster, Mr. B! Don't make me care!
Okay, so now she's draining that. I don't think there's much left in that one, but never mind. I'm not gonna hurt you, don't you worry. There we go, more bugs. Let's just get that one as well. And I didn't think... Yeah, this is a dead end over here. Oh. Okay, that sounded creepy. So there's another corpse over there, which I might actually want to do immediately. Except, you know what? Let's enter the brothel first. There we go. Look at that. The first sight we get is a dead... I think that's a rumbler, yeah. A lovely new gun, but... And then one of the female splicers impaled on a wall right here. Yeah. Straight through the mouth. So let's take this. This is my favorite gun in the whole game. This is the spear gun, and if you combine that with telekinesis, you can take the spears out of the wall, and, well, you can fire a spear into a splicer's head, and then pull it back out and use it on another one. So that's really, really cool. So, hello.
What the hell?
Yeah, what the hell indeed. Ooh, that was in the face. Self-preservation. Like that.
The Pearl was among the ritziest lodgings in Rapture. But during the war, the residents put themselves up for sale. Daniel's office is on the top floor, I believe.
So there we go. Got all the spears from that one. Thank you very much. Oh, I love the spear gun. Just the way the physics work. Hello? That was a familiar sight, wasn't it? Hello?
Where's my mark?
So let's do that. Let's take a shocker. And now let's put that in the face. Oh, wow, this is Was that a... Nope, that was a turret. So let's use the remote hack darts. There we go. Ooh, monster hacker as well. I think she's gonna die, right? You gonna die? Please die. There we go. D. Can I rename you? I can repair you, but I thought I could rename you. Do you have a name now? You're supposed to have a name. It looks like I actually just disabled him for some reason. Don't know if the handyman tonic is bugged in this version or not. So the Pearl, the Rapture, is one of Rapture's finest brothels. But as Sinclair mentions, the splicers started to putting themselves for sale as well. Are you alive or dead? She's dead. Anything in the toilet doesn't seem like it. Hello? What the? Ooh, acquire tonic, thrifty hacker. Sometimes the advertised price is just a suggestion. Make your hacked vending machines even more valuable with thrifty hacker. Hacked vending machines price, ooh, hacked vending prices are even cheaper. Don't really need that. We have a lot of money at all times, so don't really need that at all. Hope of cola and an Eve hypo and another. God damn it. Auto hack dart over here. Seems like the bed where we found Justine Jolene in, the mother of Jack Ryan from the previous game. But no audio diary here, I think, if I'm not mistaken. A bit of blood underneath the bed, but nothing of interest in this area except for a radio that I need to shut up. Yeah, there we go. Double standard. There we go.
Sure, I've had some Johns in my time, and they've all got their kinks. But I think Rupert beats all. Keeps wanting me to splice up in the act. Says it'll heighten it for both of us. I said, honey, I ain't doing it for the heights. I'm doing it for the scratch. Besides, Danny would have a fit if I started needling. He does it himself, of course. But what's good for the gander gets the goose thrown off the drop.
So for some reason, Daniel Wales doesn't want his hookers to, well, needle up, as she put it. So use Adam, which is, of course, the equivalent of drugs in this place. Let's set up a few more traps and gather this corpse here as well. So there we go, a nice hallway. And then with the Eve, let's put a few cyclone traps. Just in every direction a bit. And then one over there and one over here. There we go, that should actually do it. Gather. The annoying bit in this level is that we don't really have a nice vantage point. I could put myself over here, but that still leaves a few. And I think that's the man we're looking for.
That has to be Daniel. Hunt him down and pin his ears back, kid.
Hunt him down and pin his ears back.
Don't get in between us.
Jesus Christ, dude. There we go, he went up. So as you can see, Phosphorus Buck works a bit different than it does in the previous game. Oh wow, okay, let's... And then a few spears in her ass. Okay. Oh shit, this is starting to look bad actually. Cause this is a spider splicer as well, holy shit. Yeah, I'm not ready. Wow! That actually got me pretty close to death. Okay, didn't expect that. So that was a spider splicer, our first one, I think.
So let's safe with Daddy.
Pick her up. There we go. And now I'm gonna have to scrounge around a bit, because otherwise I'm not gonna survive this. None of these got triggered for some reason. The turret did its job a bit. But there should be... I hear the tingling of a little sister vent. So we could, well, leave her where we, where she's a bit safer. Fresh water, no health kits, it seems. No health kits. This might be a problem. No, and on the brute, where's the brute splicer body? Don't see the body of the brute. Oh, there it is. No, that's a spider splicer. Should have been around here somewhere, but I didn't get a first aid kit out of him. Eve hypo, that's something at least. For once, no food in the refrigerator. Is there something over
here? Not just any old girl.
And well, if somebody...
Oh, this is gonna have to be smart now.
Understands me. Baby!
Okay. No. Okay, that got me really, really close to death. I do need to be careful because the spear gun doesn't reload as fast as anything else. It does say 3 spears, but it takes a while until you can fire another one. But with that done, I'm gonna, at this precarious moment, I'm going to take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye.